Okay, halo halo guys, selamat datang lagi di channel Lever Eli. Okay, sekarang nih kita sama game. Wah, ini game series filmnya terkenal ya guys. Kalau teman-teman tak pernah nonton Game of Thrones, sekarang tapi kita mainin game board game tapi digital desainnya. Ya mungkin teman-teman yang tahu board game. Maksudnya istilahnya dia game papan, jadi kayak game model game yang pakai kartu. Nah, sekarang kita main versi digitalnya, jadi main game yang di bisa main di PC, pokoknya main di komputer, pokoknya versi digital. Game of Thrones board game. Oke, kita langsung aja lah tutorialnya dulu. Defend the cost. Oh belum bisa nih, belum bisa. Defend the cost doang. Learn the basic while fighting of Pirate Marauding the North. Oke, kita play. Ini game tentang game board game-nya Game of Thrones. Teman-teman yang tahu filmnya, series-nya, aku nggak terlalu ngikutin ya. Karena aku tahu sih udah cerita filmnya udah tamat sih. Oke, kita langsung aja. Defend the cause. Welcome to the kingdom of Westeros. In this mission you will take on the role of House Stark, or keluarga Stark nih. One of six great houses seeking dominance over the lands of Westeros. Ini bisa di zoom out sebentar guys. Mapnya bisa di zoom in, bisa di zoom out. Oke. Each game round has three phase, ada tiga fase. Players react to events. Planning phase. Player secretly assign order. Oh, ada tiga tahap setiap roundnya. Oke, kita jadi House of Stark, ini House of Greyjoy. Itu di mana nih? Winterfell. Masalah cerita di filmnya tuh berawal dari Winterfell ya. Oke, aku kurang paham sih, langsung aja. After 10 rounds, the player who control the most kingdom wins. Jadi player yang menaklukkan banyak kingdom. Maksudnya lambang nih, lambang kayak gini nih, lambang apa nih, kastil, ya dia paling menang. In the planning phase, player must assign order to each area where they have unit. Order. Siapa ada nih? Confirm order kode ya. Confirm saja ini. March berarti maju. In action phase, each player resolve the orders they assign. A single march order allow you to move any number of units from that area into adjacent areas. Select Winterfell to resolve your match. Kita gerakan unit kita satu ke White Harbor, ke Mount Caelion untuk mengambil kastil. Home trip. Because Winterfell is your home, no maintain control even if you have no units there, so long as it's in occupied by enemies. Winterfell ada markas kita. Kamu bisa mengawasi segala aktivitas di Winterfell. Kalau nggak ada, selama nggak ada musuh ya nggak perlu kita khawatirkan. Oke. Okay. Simbol. kalau kastil adalah yang mewakili simbol kastil dan stronghold, markas. If player mengontrol 7 markas, 7 kastil, dia akan menang langsung. Enggak perlu apa menunggu 10 ronde. Greyjoy. Start of round. Westeros cards are drawn the epic or prior. This space is skipped on the first round. Nah, kan ada kartunya guys. Jadi ini untuk game, ya game board game pasti ada. Pertama dia pasti rulesnya ada fasenya, jadi misalkan fasenya mendeploy unit, berapa unit, terus kita mau move unitnya kemana, terus kita disuruh menaklukkan wilayah atau kalau di sini sebutnya kastil, dan pasti ada kartunya, itu namanya board game guys. Kartunya biasanya ada deskripsinya nih, ada ya ini kayak ini nih, recruit new units. Oh ya, dan ada turn-nya ya, maksudnya ada gilirannya pasti go board game. Recruit new units. Oke. Footman. Footman tuh infantry. Footman, kita kirim footman ke sini. Footmen are useful for expanding your land empire. Stronghold provide 2 points of mustering. Ini kapal, karena itu pasukan berkuda ya, kavalry berarti. Kenaik are twice as powerful as footmen in battle. Oh, jadi kenaik atau kavalry lebih powerful dari infantry. Wah, jelas dong. Nothing happens. The next card drawn in the last day of summer. Nothing happens. Enjoy this rare moment of rest. Istirahat nih. Istirahat dong nih. Apa nih perangnya? Sir Roderick Castle. Raven arrive with news they rejoice. Pirates have been attacking in south. March your troops through course to defeat the sea scum. Just choose area to place in. Kayaknya di sini nih. Salah lagi, pilih dulu ya guys. Aduh lupa. Let's order. Dia unlock Consolidate Power Order. Oh, lambang mahkota mewakili power, kekuatan power. This player begin memulai game dengan 5 crown atau mahkota and can increase their crown by resolving Consolidate Power Order. Aku guys ada 5 nih. Lambang crown atau mahkota dipakai untuk keep control of area or units abandoned. Jadi tetap mengontrol area of area your units. Jadi unit mengontrol unit kita yang ada di area yang apa ya, yang belum terjamah mungkin abandoned. Beat on influence tracks, fan of wildling attacks. Okay. Consolidate Power Order. Okay. Confirm orders. Internal rebellion attack turn resolving match order of their choice. Kita gerakin sini. Confirm match. Time to show the Southeast controls what the North is made of. When marching, you're not allowed to move into more than one area that would start the battle. March all three units from Mount Kalin to Greywater Watch to begin the battle. Wah, ini baru perangnya nih. Gerakin, move, menggerakkan 3 unit, mendeploy 3 unit ke area Greywater Watch. Spend 1 crown to keep control of your carriages. Combat 3 unit lawan 2 unit. It's when the infantry at 1 its owner total strength. Di setiap 1 footman menambahkan 1 total strength. Player may then apply a force spell to get their side strength. Here we go. Let's play that move. Need jump. Bringing the strength of their side to 2. Side supper is casual this equal to number of swords. Going for Dark Mage Clay Gel fortification, let your opponent move no one has swords. Victory. Since the Grey Jaw footmen were not killed in battle, they must retreat to an adjacent area as routed unis. Oh, nggak mati ya guys, karena tadi dia punya lambang kastil, fortification. Rooted units can march and contribute no strength in combat. If a rooted unit is defeated in another combat, it is destroyed. Root units become unroot at the end of round. When the supply card is drawn, each player updates their supply limit to equal number. Okay, card supply. Supply determines the number of area players may have with 2 or more units. Supply menggambarkan jumlah area pemain yang memiliki 2 atau lebih unit. Area dengan 1 unit tidak membutuhkan supply. The current supply limits are displayed as dots next to the helmets by your supply barrel. The yellow dots show which of your supplies are in use. Okay, ada nanti ada tandanya kapan supply. If a player has lost territory since last supply card was drawn, jika player kehilangan wilayah ketika supply card terakhir diambil, they may to remove unit to confirm with their new supply. Dia harus mencabut unit-unitnya untuk mengambil confirm. Oh, menambahkan dengan kartu supply yang baru. Katanya emang gak ribet sih guys ini. You can review the supply limit associated with each barrel. Ini barrel ya. Among by selecting your new host banner. Ini barrel, cuma ada 2 nih. Game of Thrones, its player collect one player collect one crown, mahkota, for each crown icon an area he control in each control port without adjacent enemy ship. Loh, jadi siapa yang mengambil? Yang menang ya dia yang menguasai area dengan ada lambang crownnya, lambang apa mahkota tuh. Player collect one. Setiap player mengoleksi satu area, saya satu mahkota untuk satu area. Dan mereka mengontrolnya dengan satu mahkota. Planning phase. Take two more from the Greyjoy to complete the scenario.
Your men await the next order. Time to go on the offensive. From Greyjoy.
Oh, ini kartunya Greyjoy. Choose order to place. Coba kita move ke meja dulu. Suruh gerakin ke sini. Sini nih. Charles Face. You have unlocked ini, jadi kita unlock. Kita tambah kekuatan. When Clash of King is done, player beat. Okay. It's player choose the beat number of crown atau mahkota. Ya, satu aja deh. Ya, harus dua ya. Harus full 7. Ya ampun. Beat threshold. Okay. Nothing happened. Once per round of Valerian Steel Blade to use, increase your combat strength by 1 after house card. New order, support order. Choose area. Ambil dua kastil, kita ambil satu lagi. So you need to move. Enggak bisa ya, dia harus 4. Cukup ya. Nothing happened. Ini yang terjadi. bisa menaklukkan. Ini support tuh. Riverrun, the twins. Confirm art. Yo, apa tu lagi? Much. Yaduh. We may have supplies to moving this. Yeah, ini bisa lagi. Kita suruh kesini dulu. Ya, nggak bisa aja. Udah biarin aja deh. Nah, ini nih, gua butuh. Iya, aduh, udah keklik lagi. Gue butuh supply. Ampun. Aku butuh supply, guys. Ini aja support order aja dah. Mundur lo. Ya ampun, mundur lagi. Dua strength. Kita ajuin aja deh. Kalah lagi. Oke, ya pakai Aryan Steel Blade. Oh,
time warp, my lord. Please order.
End of game. Wah, akhirnya guys. Jadi ya inilah guys, Game of Thrones digital board game. Jadi mungkin teman-teman yang udah pernah main board game terus main di digital game pasti udah tahu. Pasti ada fase-fasenya, ada fase planning, move, attack. Lalu ada kayak kartu-kartunya gitu untuk menambah mungkin bisa skill atau sebagai utility untuk taktik. Jadi seperti inilah gamenya guys. Tapi tadi maksud tutorial, nanti kita coba challenge yang lain. Oke, sampai segini dulu guys video untuk kali ini, Game of Thrones board game. Terima kasih guys, kalau suka videonya boleh klik like dan subscribe. Oke guys, mungkin kita ketemu lagi di video selanjutnya. Terima kasih guys.